Have you gone back to speak with the ambassador about what was in those discussions he had with Jared Kushner, with anybody else in the Trump campaign?
No.
Never?
No, I haven't.
Are you?
No, has there been anything significant? Reported this to the minister. The minister would have reported it to me. There weren't even any reports.
Are you sure?
There's nothing to even talk about. Doesn't you believe there wasn't even any kind of specific discussion about sanctions or anything else? For me, this is just amazing. You created a sensation. Out of
how much was about to eat?
And out of the sensation, you turned it into a weapon of war against the current president.
Yeah.
Well, this is, you know, you're just, you people are so creative over there. Good job. Your lives must be boring.
Michael Flynn hasn't had a boring life. In 2015, he attended an event with President Putin in Moscow. He was later hired and then fired as President Trump's advisor.
Yeah.
He's now being investigated for his Russian connections. Did you know General Michael Flynn? He came over here for a dinner. A photo of which has been widely circulated in the American media. What was the nature of your relationship with him?
Yes, when you and I, personally have a much closer relationship than I had with Mr. Flynn. You and I met yesterday.
She's blushing.
You and I have been working together all day today, and now we're meeting again. When I came to the event for our company, Russia Today, and sat down at the table, next to me there was a gentleman sitting on one side. I made my speech, then we talked about some other stuff, and I got up and left. And then afterwards I was told, you know, there was an American gentleman who was involved in some things. He used to be in the intelligence services. That's it. I didn't even really talk to him. That's the extent of my acquaintance with Mr. Flynn.
But what about his relationship with President Trump?
I would get along with Russia, and I'll get along with Putin, and he's not going to make us look bad anymore. Well, we're going to get along.
Hell yeah.
There have been questions in America about Donald Trump's finances. He hasn't released his tax returns. There have been questions about this secret Russian dossier, which he says is fake, but which purports to have blackmail information in it generated by the Russians. There have been questions about the communications
with the
Kremlin and the Trump campaign.
You want to watch?
All of which has Americans asking, do you have something damaging on our president?
Well, this is just another load of nonsense. Where would we get this information from? Why did we have such a special relationship with him? We didn't have any relationship at all. There was a time when he used to come to Moscow, but you know, I never met with him. We have a lot of Americans who visit us. Just right now, I think we have representatives from 100 American companies that have come to Russia. Do you think we're gathering compromising information on all of them right now or something? Have you all lost your senses over there?
Toward the end of our conversation, we moved away from the election controversy to President Putin's reputation for repression. Many Americans hear the name Vladimir Putin, and they think he runs a country full of corruption.
No, a country
in which journalists who are too critical could wind up
murdered.
A country in which dissidents wind up in jail or worse.
Gave her a big piece of food.
She's starving. She's a little
hungry.
Yeah, I'm like,
he dropped it.
No one should have any doubt about that. Why do you have the right to ask us these kinds of questions and do it all the time to moralize and to give us lessons on how to live? We're ready to listen to comments that is done constructively with the goal of establishing your relationship, creating a common environment.
I don't want those burgers.
But we will absolutely not accept.
I get you something to eat here soon.
As an instrument of political conflict, I want everyone to know that. That's our message.
Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here.
All right, we got Megyn Kelly and Alex Jones up next.
Thanks for watching.
How dare you poop on my bed? Not bed.
You be pooping on my bed?
How dare you pee on my bed? Poop millions of times in one night.
So let's start with. I'll
beat you.
Click on shit.
Here we go. All I can do is give you my word and tell you I.
that if there's one thing about me, I do what I say I'm going to do, and I don't double cross. So,
you know, you just became very fascinating to me. I just sort of thought you were maybe, you know, one-dimensional guy, like this is your thing.
My goal is for your listeners and the left, you know, who will be watching some on NBC to say, wow, that was really interesting. And then the next time I want to get somebody, they're going to say, look what you did to Alex Jones. It's not going to be some gotcha hit piece, I promise you that.
We talked controversies and conspiracies. 9/11.
Now, 9/11 was an inside job. When I say inside job, it means criminal elements in our government.
What was the full one? Not just a...
wanted to frame Iraq.
This is the InfoWars version.
Okay. You... I rewatched the InfoWars after, because like, I want to build up my own opinions first. I feel like that's how you should become a YouTuber. You should first formulate your opinion and then watch other people's take on it.
Good idea. It always brings me to this, and this one's at the top. Alright, this is also from Alex Jones. This is also from Alex Jones. Alex Jones, Alex Jones, Alex Jones, Alex Jones. Conspiracy scope.
Okay.
I don't.
All I can do is give you my word.
I think.
I thought it was like the live interview.
I think they didn't do the interview. I mean, they did the interview, but I think it was disallowed. Like, it never actually was aired on TV. I think they, like, they really came down on Megyn Kelly for doing this.
Hold on a second. No fucking way. The one place he'll be anywhere. It's Google. How do you spell this shit?
Megyn Kelly interviews Alex Jones. Do you know how to spell Alex?
Yeah.
Okay.
Kelly.
Killies, but Killy.
Kelly. Yeah, that's fine. Kelly at who? What the fuck? Okay, so let's talk.
Why? No way. Interviews interview with Donald Trump, Jimmy Fallon, Putin. What?
The first is trying to scare me.
Just the neighbors.
Oh shit, is this actual full interview?
Promise you that.
I guess so. This is the best we're gonna get. It's at the top, it has the most
all
views
I can do
over
is give
a million.
My word and tell you, if there's one thing about me, I do what I say I'm gonna do. And I don't double cross, so.
You know, you just became very fascinating to me.
Oh shit, get that bird away from me.
So, she forgot you to peck your ear?
Yeah.
Okay. My goal is for your listeners and the left, you know, who will be watching some on NBC to say,
down.
Wow, that was really
step down.
Interesting. And then the next
step
time
down.
I want to get somebody,
down.
They're going to say, look what you did
down.
To Alex Jones.
Down.
It's not going to be some gotcha hit piece, I promise you that.
I'm sorry.
We talked controversies and conspiracies. 9/11.
Now, 9/11 was an inside job. When I say inside job, it means criminal elements in our government
up
working with Saudi Arabia and others.
Up.
Iraq. It's a fact.
You are about to view and listen to information that's never before been seen or heard. In the past, NSM, corporate media, could tell the truth, they could lie, they could spin. It was
up to them.
They were the gods of information.
I think she'll stick around.
But Megyn Kelly waltzed in here.
She gets up on that roof. I'll just climb up on up there with her.
And told me that she wasn't going to talk about Sandy Hook. She wasn't going to talk about Pizzagate. She wasn't going to talk about Chobani. She wasn't going to talk about Islamic terror attacks. That she wanted to do a softball profile of Alex Jones.
Softball profile.
And when she got here with her crew of intelligence operatives, she did the opposite of what she said. And so I was recording the whole time. From our pre-interviews, right through the interviews, we have a record of it so that you can decide for yourself what I really said and what I stood for. These tyrants haven't figured it out yet that information warfare is a two-way street. And we're going to give as good as we get. And that's what you're about to see. You alone will be the judge. You alone will be the jury of who's fake news and who stands for America and who stands against it. I'm Alex Jones, and this is the InfoWar.
Well,
I'm
starting my new job in Harvard, and we're going to serve breakfast on Monday night. You're just like anybody. You're your dad. You're the same thing we go through, and I thought.